Hello everybody. Thanks for 400 subscribers. If you notice, today I'm filming in my room, and that's a little bit representative of the topic I'm going to be talking about. It's going to be about MIT and the impact of COVID on MIT life. Let's get started. Let's begin by going back to March. So back then in March, very few people took the pandemic seriously. So it was all just kind of like something going around in the background that didn't really affect us, as in MIT students, a lot. The MIT bubble seemed unbreakable, you know? What you experience at MIT just feels like you experience it there. There's no outside world at all. So that all changed on a couple days in March. I remember those days as if it were like yesterday. Basically, the tensions during those days, the tension was so high. I remember going to lecture and recitation and not being able to basically soak in any information at all. It was just so distracting because there were some rumors circulating that the pandemic has gotten so bad that the administration would kick us out of campus. And back then, that was basically like unthinkable because of the MIT bubble, like I said. We didn't think that anything outside of it would affect us. So for something like this to happen, this was such a major thing for us to be kicked out. So these rumors really set the tensions high. Basically, well, the professors and recitation leaders tried their best to teach the material, but I personally couldn't soak in any of it, basically. I remember a lot of things about those days, but the material that I was supposed to learn, I don't remember any of it. And I remember this very specific moment. I was in one of the physics lecture halls, and basically one of my fellow peers interrupted the professor and told the news. Basically, an image of this memo sent to the fraternities had been leaked, and it said that we were going to be kicked out that weekend. This was during the week, right? It was a weekday. I was going to classes, and that weekend we were supposed to be kicked out. We were supposed to leave campus, all of us. And that moment was really intense. Like, some people started crying. Some people literally just up and left the lecture room, like that. And the rest of us who stayed, we just, like, could not focus on the material. I remember the professor was like, oh, this is a really high tension time. It's really stressful, but let's take some time to just learn some physics. And I don't think any of us really learned any physics that day, to be honest. Those couple days of high tensions and waiting to hear from the administration and then finally hearing this rumor and then that rumor being confirmed basically either that day or the next day, that was all just really high tension and some of the most stressful days of my time at MIT. So basically after that was trying to figure out what to do. So I call my parents, all flustered, and be like, oh, you know, I need a flight back. I was really stressed out. You know, have to book a flight in a couple days. It's pretty crazy. And then it was all stress about what am I going to do with all my stuff. Because MIT was like, oh, you need to pack as if you're never going to like come back for a while. And basically, initially, they only gave us a certain amount of boxes to put all of our stuff in. But I don't know, not only me, but a lot of people were like, oh, I have too much stuff to put in all these boxes, what am I gonna do? Am I going to have to throw away all of my stuff? It was really stressful. I remember that being an issue for a while, and then some people in the dorms seeking extra boxes and trying to deal with all that. And then, luckily, MIT made a deal with this moving company called Piece by Piece, and we were allowed all sorts of extra boxes and stuff to go with that, so that was good. It really helped, and that was basically the only stress reliever during that period of time. It was crazy. Another thing I really remember about that time period is my hall in my dorm. We had just a final kind of last meeting, and everybody was sharing these stories, and I remember just like breaking down and crying because it had finally sunk in that I wouldn't see these people for a while, maybe if ever. I started crying, and it was the first time I cried in front of all these like hallmates, generally, I tended to be pretty stoic, so it kind of shocked some of them, I think, if I remember correctly. And some of the people who I didn't necessarily find myself particularly close to started talking to me, and some gave me hugs. There were lots of hugs that day. And I got to talk to some of the people who, like I said, I don't think I'll ever see again, some of them. It was really sad. Yeah. And after that hall meeting, I remember going to my room and just like completely breaking down. I was freaking out because it had finally sunk in that, like, you know, the most important part of MIT to me, the most vital part of it, the community, was being taken away from me, and there was nothing I could do about it. And I think this is something that a lot of people, a sentiment a lot of my peers really share at MIT. It was really, really stressful for me because of it, because being a physics major who's not necessarily particularly good at math or these other skills that you need to be a physics major, it's pretty essential for me to work with other people when I do my PSETs and the other work I have to do, because I feel like I just am not capable enough to do it myself. And MIT really provides that community and that support through community, but it's, back then, I was just thinking, oh, all of that is just being taken away. And it was really bad. So I was breaking down in my room about that, and luckily there were a couple friends who came and just sat with me and chatted with me about it, and they didn't say it would be okay, because, you know, obviously it wouldn't be okay, but their presence really helped me back then. And, you know, some of these friends are some of those people who I think I'll never see again, so I'm just really grateful for them for being there with me during my time of just like freaking out. Bring some good memories, at least, for the last time I was able to see them. Anyway, so I flew away from MIT campus, and MIT life really changed very drastically, in some very predictable ways. So all classes went online. The administration basically made it so that all classes were pass no record, which was really convenient, because then didn't have to worry about grades. And it was also convenient, very convenient for me, because two of the classes I was taking that semester were two of the hardest classes in my major, physics. So I was really, really grateful for that. There's no way I would have been able to do very well during that time, especially without PSET partners. And on top of that, a lot of the professors were really, really understanding about the situation. I'd like to give a shout out to Professor Condry, Ian Condry. He basically was teaching this class about East Asian music culture, and he was like, oh, all of you guys, all the students, you all pass, I'll give you passing grades, and all of the work you put in now is optional. And actually, I ended up learning quite a lot from that class, despite him saying that. And some of the stuff I learned then still sticks with me now. So it's kind of it kind of gives some credit to the idea that, you know, classes don't have to be so strict and have all this, like, tons of work and really strict deadlines and stuff for students to be able to learn. So, kind of show some proof for that sentiment. Anyway, that was really nice of him, and really took an awful lot of stress from that class. As the semester went on, administration started giving more and more updates about the situation, and by the time, like, you know, summer hit, I was having severe doubts about being able to return. This past fall semester, I wasn't on campus still. I was not invited back. And also, I was kind of worried about my stuff. So my stuff is all packed in boxes, through piece by piece. And I still don't know where it is, or like how I'm going to be able to access it at some point. That's been kind of still a stressor. It was back then, still is. Yeah. But, you know, there were still some highlights to this. So during the spring semester, despite everything going to hell, my research I was working on at that point paid off with a research paper, which was really nice. And I also got a new project during the summer that was interesting and fulfilling, that I worked on, have continued this past fall. It was kind of disappointing because instead of doing that new research, I was supposed to go to Japan through MIT's MISTI program, which is their abroad program where you get to go abroad and either intern at a company or do research at a university abroad. I was supposed to go to Japan through that program, and that was all canceled because basically all the borders are closed. So that was really unfortunate, but I did some research instead, and that's been interesting, and I've been trying to follow through with that. It's been difficult, but still interesting to me. Yeah, so, you know, the opportunities and things that MIT provides are still there, ultimately. They're pretty easy to access. MIT makes it pretty easy to access, you know, research or other opportunities for people in academia. But ultimately, you know, the very essential and very vital and important and redeeming qualities about MIT, basically, the most important of those qualities is the community. It's not the very difficult classes. It's not the, you know, academic and professional opportunities. It's not all of these things that you could find at other universities. The special thing that sets MIT apart and that's super important about it to all the students there is the community. It's the support from this community. It's the atmosphere created by the community of basically working together all to get through this really difficult experience that is MIT. There's very, very little competition at MIT because of it. We're all part of this, you know, part of this machine, part of this community that's just trying to get through all these difficult things that MIT puts us through. It's the times when you're up super late p-setting with people, and it's like, I don't know, 2 or 3 a.m., you finally finish this p-set with your p-set partners, and you all turn it in, whether with, you know, feelings of relief or resignation, whatever it is. It's that kind of sentiment. It's the times when, I don't know, somebody brings cookies to the group so that you can all, you know, have some form of happiness while you're all working on this tough p-set together. You know, it's, I don't know, going out with your friends to hot pot or KBBQ or boba to de-stress after a long week working. It's these kinds of things that really make MIT what MIT is. And the pandemic's really taken that away. So, you know, it doesn't really feel like MIT anymore, even though I've been taking MIT classes, I'm still an MIT student, I still pay basically full tuition, like, all of these things are still in place, but it doesn't really feel like I'm at MIT, unfortunately. And so because of that, I really hope that, you know, things go back normal now that the vaccine is in place, and hopefully, you know, things will get a bit better. And that's kind of how the MIT experience has really changed. Yeah, I'm really hopeful for the future, but, you know, it'll probably take a while to transition back into how things used to be. And, you know, even though I'm still invited back as a student in the spring, this coming spring, I'm invited back since I'm a junior, I probably won't go because the experience there is not going to be what it was like I was just describing, of like, you know, working together and things, because, you know, there's going to be strict social distancing guidelines. You know, you have to test for COVID, you take COVID tests all the time. You can't just go everywhere freely, run into people however you'd like, you know, work together late into the night. There's none of that. So I'm probably not going to go back. I have an apartment with some of my friends. We're basically just going to try and live out the pandemic together. And that's just how things are going to be. Yeah, so that was basically an explanation of how MIT life changed because of the pandemic. Thanks for listening. Hope you learned something interesting and new. And I'll see you next time. Bye!